So in this video, we're going to take a look at how we find the midpoint between two coordinates. So if we take a look at this grid, we've got the points A and B. And the coordinates of point A are -2, -3. And the coordinates of point B are 4, 1. So to find the midpoint between these two points, we can use our midpoint formula, which looks something like this. We can find our x-coordinate of our midpoint by doing x1 plus x2 and then dividing the result of that by 2. And we can find the y-coordinate of the midpoint by doing y1 plus y2 and then dividing that by 2. So when we see x1, that just means the x-coordinate from our first point A, and x2 would be our x-coordinate from our second point B. And then the same for the y-coordinates. Our y1 would be our y-coordinate from our point A, and our y2 would be our y-coordinate from point B. So we can now start substituting into our formula. Starting with x1 and x2, well, these are the x-coordinates from both A and B, which are -2 and 4. So we'd be doing -2 plus 4 here, and then we still need to divide that by 2. And then substituting our y1 and y2, they would just be our y-coordinates from A and B, which would be -3 and 1. So now that we've substituted into our formula, we can simplify. So starting with the x-coordinate of the midpoint, looking at the numerator, we've got -2 add 4. Well, that would just simply be 2. So now we've got 2 over 2. And then for our y-coordinate of our midpoint, looking at that numerator, we've got -3 plus 1. Well, that would give us -2. So we've now got -2 over 2. Now for our final step, we can simplify further. For our x-coordinate of our midpoint, we've got 2 divided by 2, which would be 1. And for our y-coordinate, we've got -2 divided by 2. Well, that would be -1. So the coordinates of our midpoint between the points of A and B would be 1, -1. Which I've marked on the grid with the letter M. So now that we know how to use our midpoint formula, we can take a look at a few more examples. So feel free to pause the video here, grab a pen and paper and have a go at these, and we'll go through the solutions in just a few moments. Okay, so for this first question, we want to find the midpoint between the points of A and B. So looking at our two points, we've got point A, which has coordinates -4, 2. And we have point B that has coordinates 2, 4. So now starting with the x-coordinate of our midpoint, we're simply going to add our x-coordinates together. So that would be -4 plus 2. And then we're going to divide that by 2. And then we're going to add our y-coordinates together. So that would be 2 plus 4 divided by 2. So now simplifying our numerators, we've got -4 plus 2. Well, that's just going to give us -2. And then we've got 2 plus 4. Well, that's going to give us 6. So now for our final step, we need to do -2 divided by 2. Well, that would be -1. And then we're going to do 6 divided by 2, well, that would give us 3. So our midpoint between the points of A and B would sit here at coordinates -1, 3. Okay, for this next question, we want to find the midpoint between the points of B and C. Well, our coordinates for B would be 2, 4. And our coordinates for C would be 4, -2. So now we can substitute these into our midpoint formula. We're going to add our x-coordinates together. So we'd be doing 2 plus 4, and we're then going to divide that by 2. And then adding our y-coordinates together, we've got 4. We'd be then adding -2. Well, we've got opposite signs there. A positive and a negative would make a negative. So this is the same as doing 4 take away 2. Still divided by 2. So now we want to simplify the numerators. So we do 2, add 4, which is going to give us 6. And then we're going to do 4, take away 2, well, that would give us 2. And then for our final step, we're going to do 6 divided by 2, which is 3. And then 2 divided by 2, which is 1. And that would be the coordinates for our midpoints between the points of B and C, which would sit here on the grid at 3, 1. Okay, we now want to find the midpoints between C and D. Well, if we look at C first, that has coordinates 4, negative 2. And D has coordinates negative 2, negative 5. So now substituting into our midpoint formula, we're going to add the x coordinates together. So we're going to do 4 plus negative 2. Well, a positive and a negative make a negative. So we're going to be doing 4 take away 2, which is over 2. And then adding our y coordinates together, we've got negative 2. We'd be adding on negative 5. Well, again, a positive and a negative make a negative. So here we'll be doing take away 5 over 2. So now simplifying the numerators, we've got 4 take away 2, which is just 2. And then we've got negative 2 take away 5. Well, that would leave us negative 7. And then we're going to simplify one more time. We've got 2 divided by 2, which is 1. And then we've got negative 7 divided by 2. Well, that would be negative 3.5. So we're going to have negative 3.5. So we can now plot this on our grid. We go 1 across in the x-axis. And then we're coming down by 3.5. So our midpoint would sit there on the grid. And then for our final question, we want to find the midpoint between the points D and A. Well, starting with D, we want to look at the coordinates. D has coordinates of negative 2, negative 5. And A has the coordinates negative 4, 2. So again, we can substitute these now into our midpoint formula. So we're going to add the x coordinates together. So we've got negative 2 plus negative 4. Well, a positive and a negative make a negative. So we're going to have take away 4 here over 2. And then we're going to add our y coordinates together. So we've got negative 5 plus 2, which we then still need to divide by 2. Okay, now simplifying the numerators, we've got negative 2, take away 4, that's going to give us negative 6. And then we've got negative 5 plus 2, well, that would give us negative 3. And then we can simplify one final time. If we do negative 6 divided by 2, that's going to give us negative 3. And if we do negative 3 divided by 2, that's going to give us negative 1.5. So negative 1.5. And that would be the coordinates of our midpoint. So we can plot this on the grid, negative 3 in the x direction, and then negative 1.5 in the y direction. So it would go there. So well done if you followed along with those questions. And that's it for this video. If you want to check out any other videos on working with coordinates, then I've left some links for them down in the description, and I've also put a card in the top corner, so feel free to check them out. I hope you found this video useful. If you did, please feel free to leave a like and consider subscribing. If there are any other topics at all that you'd like me to go through next, then please just let me know down in the comments, and I'll try to make some videos on those topics as soon as possible. So thank you very much for watching. And I'll see you in the next video.